Hello, I'm Bob Culbertson. I'm sitting in for George Arima. George has gotten held up tonight. But welcome to Short Track Racing. And we're here for another show. And I got with me here tonight Mario Campi, Mario Jr., and Mario Jr.'s son Anthony. And we got three generations of racing here. And the new generation here is getting a good start. He's off and running with this little cart you see here in front of us. Mario Sr., tell us a little bit about your racing career and where it began and what classes.
Bob, we started racing in Freeport, Long Island. Mm-hmm. That was about the only track that we raced at. We raced there for 3 years with my brothers, my brother Don, my brother Anthony. We raced under the Campi brothers. Mm-hmm. We won two championships in 2 years in the street stock division. It was called Bombers up there, but it was basically a street stock division. We made a little try at the open wheel modifieds up there, but it was just really tough running four cars. We ran three nights a week up there with 125 cars in a class.
Three nights a week.
So to win a point championship, it took a really big concerted effort on everybody's part to keep those cars going. You had to qualify every night to get into the feature event. We moved down here to Florida. I started to race in they call it the modified class over here, and Junior wanted to get into racing, and there again we had no pit crew, we didn't know too many people, and we had a little bit of help, and I decided not to run the modifieds and help Junior out in his racing career, and we raced a lot of years with Junior in his racing career.
Well, I know from my racing that it's awful hard to keep one car running, much less four. I'd say that'd be near impossible.
Well, all four of us worked on the cars. Whoever drove their car worked on their car, and we had two or three fellas that worked for us in the business up there. That really enjoyed the racing, and they pitched in for us. And it's really unique. We were so close to the racetrack, we used to actually drive the cars over there. We're only like a block and a half away from the racetrack.
Oh, I can remember those days, but I didn't have the money for a trailer.
And we used to drive them over there, and it made life a lot easier, you know.
Right.
Except when you wrecked them, it was tough to get them home.
Right. Were they in four different classes?
No, it was all the same class.
All the same class.
Yes. I raced against, we have some news clippings. Myself and my brothers finished 1, 2, 3 in the race, and we thought it was a pretty good deal.
Right. Well, I wish maybe we'd have gotten some of those clips and got them to put them on video so we could have them on the show, but I didn't even...
Well, back in those days, Bob, it was 8mm film.
Yeah, I understand that. Well, Mario Jr., tell us a little bit about your career at DeSoto.
Well, I started out at DeSoto, Bob, when I was about 15. I ran some stock mini stock for a couple of years, and then I went to modified minis, ran that for about 4 or 5 years, and then we went to street stocks and pure stocks, and then finally ended it at late model class.
Right. And I remember when you were running, when you first started running mini stock out there. I don't remember what year you started, but I've been videotaping out there since 1983. I think that's pretty well covered your career out there, didn't it?
I think we started in 1981.
Oh, did you? Well, you were a little before I was out there then. But yeah, I remember years with you and Billy Torkstoff and a bunch of them. That was really some good years. And you did pretty good in a late model too.
Yeah, we drove 2 years in a late model. Drove for Donnie McDonough.
Right.
McDonough
yeah,
Plumbing. And we had a really good time doing that.
Yeah, that's DeSoto is really a nice weekly racetrack. I think probably the best weekly racetrack I've ever seen. I've been around racing 42 years, and you know, I don't think I've seen a track that was better suited for weekly racing. And I mean, it's a good facility. The restrooms, the grandstands, just the pits, everything is just immaculate. You know, it's. Some of the tracks you go to are just so in such a shoddy condition. Of course, I guess if that's what you grow up under, you know, you never miss having anything else. But tell us a little bit about Anthony's career here. How long has he been racing, and
Well, Anthony started running a class called baby carts, which is a little bit smaller than this cart, when he was 4 years old.
Right.
And he ran that for about
four years old?
Yep.
My goodness.
Right, when he was four.
Grandpa did that, I would imagine.
No, it wasn't
me. No, it wasn't Grandpa.
It wasn't me.
And 4 years old.
He ran the baby cart for 2 years, and then we just moved up to this cart about 6-7 months ago.
Right. Well, tell us a little bit about Anthony's cart here, and I don't know that much about go-karts. I never raced go-karts when I was coming up, and my kids never did either. Just tell us a little bit about the cart.
This is a Coyote chassis. It was built in New York, and we run a Briggs & Stratton 5-horsepower engine. It's built by Advanced Racing Engines, and basically that's about it. The car runs about, at the track we run at Sarasota, it runs about 45 miles an hour. And that's pretty much it.
The restricted plates.
When they run in this class, how many laps do they run, and how do they work their points and all?
Well, they run 3 races per day. Mm-hmm. He runs 2 8-lap heat races.
Okay.
And then a 10-lap feature.
Now, how do they decide who gets into the feature and what position they start?
Well, basically all the carts get into the feature, and whoever has the most points by the third race starts first.
Okay, that's a pole. That's how they decide to pole.
Mm-hmm.
I understand this thing's got some computer equipment on it. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
It has what's called a Pi racing system on it, which basically gives us a bunch of readings. So that when Anthony comes in from practice, we can plug into a computer in our trailer, and we can tell if the cart is pushing or if it's loose or if it's got a miss in it or a bunch of different things.
Well, that sounds like a winner. That sounds like a high-tech go-kart to me. boy, I tell you. Okay, we're going to take a break. Come back with us to Short Track Racing. We'll be back in just a little bit.
Racing at the Desoto Speedway. 6 thrilling divisions of racing every Saturday night. Late models, open wheel modifieds, street stocks, pure stocks, miniature stocks, and novice stocks. Great food and always plenty of free parking. Children under 5 admitted free. Take the whole family for a thrill a minute at one of the best short tracks in the state of Florida. The Desoto Speedway, 8 miles east of I-75 on State Road 64.
Hello, I'm Mike Flanagan, the owner of the Sarasota Wine Club, located at 4607 South Tamiami Trail. I'd like to extend an invitation for you folks to join me every other Sunday evening on Blab TV 36 to watch my wine show. We'll be discussing topics related for the wine-conscious consumer and introduce you to interesting personalities from the world of wine. So, see you on Sunday evening at 8:30 on Blab TV 36. Cheers!
Hamsters.
Fish, because they swim.
They tickle me.
Birds.
Animal Crackers has a perfect pet for you to love. Exotic birds, fish, reptiles, and other small animals. We're home to the largest selection of tame and talking parrots. Plus, we carry all the supplies, pet food, and toys you'll ever need. Animal Crackers at the Parkway Collection, corner of University and Lockwood.
Birds attack are cool.
Hola, soy Germán Calderón. Y le invito a que vea mi programa en español, El Mensaje Latino, en TV. El segundo y cuarto lunes del mes, a las 9:30 de la noche, por Canal 36 en Sarasota, Blab TV, y Canal 58 en Bradenton. No se lo pierda.
Welcome back to Short Track Racing. I'm Bob Culbertson again, and with me here is Mario Jr. and Anthony camping. And we were out at the Gulf Coast Cartway this past Sunday with their races and doing a little bit of videotaping out there of Anthony and some of his activities. And if we can roll that tape now, Dave, we'll see what we got out there. We can, guys, we can talk over this when you see. There's the bunch.
It looks like the driver's meeting we're at.
Right.
As you can see, it's really a family event out there. The husbands, the wives, the children, and anybody who's racing. That's actually pit road that you're looking at. And Bob's got a couple of shots here of that's a shifter cart. Those things are awesome. People should just come out the Gulf Coast Cartway just to watch those shifter carts run. It's really a unique experience. Just some of the other different classes of carts. There's a number of different classes of carts that people could get involved in, and two-cycle, four-cycle, and the shifter carts, which are like would be like your super modifieds. Really interesting. Spectators could watch the races for free out there on Sunday afternoon. Races start at 12 o'clock. Warm-ups start about 9 o'clock.
There we are.
Looks like a picture of our cart. It's had our fiberglass nose on it.
There's your computer.
There's the computer box in there. The pedals, as you can see. The unique thing about these carts is the children, as they grow up, they could continually use the same cart just by changing the seat. There's the computer in our trailer that we download the information after Anthony comes in from a practice session or a race. This looks like Anthony getting ready to go out there. About this time, his daddy gets a little butterflies in his stomach, as I used to get when Mario Jr. started to race. But Anthony is calm, cool, and collective, and really enjoys it.
Yeah, he's ready to get on with it.
As the safety equipment, have to wear gloves, full jacket, full pants, also a neck brace. You'll see the neck brace going on here in a second. And Dad'll have a couple words with Anthony.
Yeah, it's.
But it's really great to see these children race at 7, 8, 9 years old, and they have classes out there for over 35 year old.
Right. Well, I was really impressed Sunday when I was out there with all the safety and everybody.
The cart goes through its safety tech inspection every week.
Right.
Every week.
His last minute words from Daddy.
Yep. We had 6 carts in the rookie class on Sunday.
Oh, there's Grandpa.
There's Grandpa. Oh. He gets a little nervous, too.
I can imagine. Here we go.
We all get nervous until Anthony gets out there and starts to do his thing. And
yeah, he's quite the little guy. He's. I heard you tell him there you needed to get him an alarm clock.
Sunday. Yeah, he had a little bit of a slow start Sunday. We dropped him back almost into third spot there. We made a couple of good moves getting back up there and started second. There he goes. He just took over the lead right there.
There's the lead. Yeah, he's.
Mario Jr.'s been working on a setup on the cart. We were out there practicing all day Saturday, trying some different setups on it. And we got him pretty well hooked up. And as you can see, he's taking a pretty awesome lead there. If he could break away out of the pack, not having to run through any traffic, he was running about 6/10 to 8/10 of a second faster than the second place cart.
I tell you what, he was moving. There's no question about that. I don't know as far as time. I'm taping it. I didn't have time to tape.
The cart will travel about 47 miles an hour. Mm-hmm. Runs that track in 29.50 seconds.
Yeah, he seems like he's quite a bit faster than all those fellows behind him.
Tribute that to the crew chief.
There you go. Is that Dad or is that Grandpa?
That's Dad.
Oh.
That's Dad.
Yeah, it was a checkered flag.
He does a lot of work on the setups and stuff.
And here we come with
There we go. We have to go through tech. We have to weigh in. Our minimum weight is 250 pounds. We pushed over the scale on Sunday at 251 pounds.
There you go.
We told Anthony to have another hamburger and a Coke before he went out next race so we'd make weight. We'll go back to the trailer and download our information.
Yeah, that's quite the rig. Yeah, it's he's getting congratulations from everybody there. Oops, there goes Mama and Grandma.
Yeah, Grandma's out there. Grandma's a big supporter of Anthony's, and so is Jeannie and Amanda. We have a good time as a family. It's a great family sport.
Now that's a job.
Yeah, cleaning the tires. I am lubing it up, making sure that everything is free and spinning free. But it's a great family sport. It's really nice to be out there with your families.
Right. Well, that's a great team you got there. It's really impressive. You know, it's just like the big guys. You know.
Yeah. Well, it takes a team effort in racing,
yeah,
Bob. As you well know, it's not a thing where you could just go out there as an individual. It's real tough. Just lugging the cart around. You know, you need two pretty good, strong people lifted up.
Well,
and
I
down.
Can tell that the way my back is. I don't think I can carry it around very much. But well, with that, we're going to go to a break. I'm going to be on the other end of the camera after this break because George has got here. But I'm usually on the back side of the camera instead of this side. But I hope you hadn't had too much trouble putting up with me. But we'll be right back with Short Track Racing.
My family depends on me, and when it comes to keeping the van up and running, I depend on Bill Graham Ford. They understand that my time is valuable, so they don't keep me waiting. When I schedule a service appointment with Bill Graham Ford, I know that I'll be taken care of promptly, and that my van will be ready when they say, with no unexpected surprises. My family trusts that I'll be there for them, and I trust Bill Graham Ford.
Bill Graham Ford. Great deals, great service, and great people.
Facts about haircutting. It takes years of training to do a precision haircut. Only experienced stylists should be cutting your hair. The most respected name is New York Hair Company. Family owned. Established in 1980 here in Sarasota. 6 convenient locations specializing in permanent waving and all phases of hair coloring. New York Hair Company.
Spine and Sports Therapy. Dr. William E. McComb and Lourdes Batista, MD, treating all types of auto, sports, and work-related injuries with the latest therapy and treatment of the musculoskeletal system. You don't have to be an athlete to be treated by sports medicine techniques to get well. For your appointment for auto, sports, or work-related injuries, call Lourdes Batista, MD, or Dr. William E. McComb at the Spine and Sports Therapy, located in the Clock Building in Sarasota and the Bolotari Sports Academy in Bradenton.
If you're into boating, you ought to get to know Marine Surplus. They specialize in hard-to-find marine supplies and accessories. You'll find everything you need in boating, from anchors to zincs, in their 21,000 square feet of boating supplies and accessories. Just a mile and a half north of the airport on Old U.S. Highway 301. Marine Surplus is open from 9 to 5, Monday through Saturday, to serve all your boating needs. No need to spend a bundle. Shop Marine Surplus. Find what you need and save.
Hello, welcome back to Short Track Racing. No, I'm not Bob. And if you're tooling down the highway and that little gauge on the right-hand side's on E, it doesn't mean enough. I will tell you that. We are with the Campies from Royal Tees, and Anthony Campney drives in the Gulf Coast Karting Association. And Anthony, how old are you?
6.
And how long have you been racing these things?
3 years.
Wow, and I was out there Saturday, and I watched you pick up another win.
Mm-hmm.
And in what class is this called?
Purple.
This is a purple class. Is that a division of an age group? Is that the way they define the classes?
Purple actually means what size restrictor plate is on it.
So they
have a purple, a turquoise, and a gold.
Okay.
And his has a purple one on it.
And your engine, your cart has a restrictor plate on it. Now, I had noticed Saturday the sophistication of these are pretty much like the Indy League cars. There's a speed sensor up on the tires and the wheels, Mario, that you were showing me. And there's a throttle and a brake sensor that tells exactly when he's on and off the throttles.
Correct.
And I guess it downloads it into the computer, and then you send it into the trailer, and then you can analyze what is actually the amount of time that he spends going in and coming off of the corners. That just fascinates me. Have any of your late models or anything, Mr. Campy, ever done anything like that? I mean, have they implicated any kind of a computer system like that?
No, but we understand a couple of fellas who run late models are experimenting with it.
With it now?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
This was mainly an indie type car situation.
Right, like the IRLs?
The Pi system, yeah.
How often out there at the airport do you race out there? How many times a month?
We run twice a month out there.
You run twice a month out there?
Mm-hmm.
How many different young men are in your division that racing with you? Four, five, or six of them?
Seven.
There's seven guys that you race against? And he's got quite a few wins, doesn't he? I mean, 8, 10, 12 in a row or something? How many wins have you got now?
How many trophies do you have, Anthony?
Probably 20 or something.
Whoa. Excellent. And you've been racing how long?
3 years.
Wonderful. Now, the sophistication of these carts, Mario and I were laughing and joking. Mario and I used to race street stocks together. And Mario said we could have built us a whole brand new street stock for the expense of one of these. Now, when I had first walked in a little while ago, when you had Bob on the show here, you were elaborating that it is a good family sport.
Excellent family sport, George. Excellent.
And it's keeping the family ties pretty tight and united.
Well, yes, I really enjoy it. I think there's a lot of other families out there, a lot of father and son race teams in the purple class and on up, even up a little bit higher than that. The dads are out there with their sons on Sunday, and they're working together. You've been saying Saturday, but it's the first and third Sunday of every month.
The first and third
first
Sunday.
First and third Sunday of every month we race out there.
Okay. The motor, let's start off with the motors a little bit. The engines that are on here, are they like spec engines, or can anybody build their own engines?
The engines, they have a really strict set of rules to go by.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't choose to build our own engines. We have advanced racing engines build them for us.
Okay. When it comes to sponsors, like Short Track Racing is pretty well involved, you know, trying to acquire sponsors for the series. Does that fall into play in karting? I mean, is it an advantage to someone to try to come up with sponsors, or is that not pretty much emphasized in karting?
Sure, it hasn't been prevalent in karting, George. I think maybe when they go to national events, somebody might pick up a motor sponsor or a chassis sponsor, something like that. We haven't seen a great deal of
corporate
sponsors on it at this point in time. But karting is picking up in popularity. Don't let the viewers out there get shook up with the sophistication we have on the kart. You could get into karting relatively inexpensively and have a competitive kart.
Right.
I know a friend of mine bought one for his son. It cost him just a little over $1,000. Was a used kart, and it was a very competitive kart also.
Well, that's worth its weight in gold, like you say, for the family values. Now, your kart is very sophisticated, and of course, everybody knows Royal Tees here in Sarasota. Which you guys own helps keep the sophistication running. Do you share some of this knowledge with the others, some that aren't fortunate enough to be able to have this sophistication? In other words, if you pick up something that's you feel prevalent to the other carters, you guys like sit with them and help them out a little bit?
Well, George, you know, it's like any other sport. You know, you make certain friends and you make certain, I don't want to say enemies, but...
Rivalries,
I should say. And, you know, you try and keep it... We like to help people out, and sure. The biggest thing is when we move out of a class, we'll really help the people. Like we were giving some people a hand with the kids' carts out there on Sunday, and they were having little problems with it. As a matter of fact, one of the fellas asked Anthony to hop in the cart and drive it to see what he could pick up if his son was doing a good enough job on it. And we found out that it was actually the motor on the cart that wouldn't go anywhere, because I think Anthony flat-footed it all the way around the racetrack and just didn't want to go anymore, you know. So. But it's like any other racing, you know, we like to win out there, and,
sure.
and we work real hard at, and Junior works real hard at different setups in the kart, and the kart is very, very well prepared. We didn't have a DNF because of a motor problem or mechanical failure with this kart all year, so.
What kind of prep time do you have in it? You know, prepping for each race, what kind of prep time do you get?
I normally spend probably about 5 hours a week working on it and just
Does
checking.
Anthony come in and help you in the garage?
Oh, yeah,
and,
all the time.
Make sure everything's okay?
Anthony helps wash it down and wipe it down every week. And
excellent.
You know, we go through every nut and bolt on it and check everything to make sure nothing came loose.
Okay. Well, thanks for watching Short Track Racing. And again, Mr. Campy and Anthony Campy here from the Gold Coast Karting Association. We want to thank you, and this is a different form of racing. We suggest that a family values are there, and if you want to get into racing, like most all other Winston Cup stars, they've all started right here. Thanks again. I'm the late George Auriemma for Short Track Racing. We'll see you next week right here on Blab TV, Channel 36. Thanks, and have a great night.